A very good morning to all of you students, and once again welcome back to our online classes of English language standard 5th. Students, in the last period we have done introduction, and from today's period we are going to start our syllabus. Students, up to now you may have studied so many things in grammar, because in 4th standard also you are having English language. And in that you have studied nouns, pronouns, verbs, adverbs and so many things. So students, if I want to ask you one thing, what is the meaning of sentence? So obviously you will say that sentence is a group of words. Okay? And when we form a sentence, we divide these words, 8 words, into different parts, and that is known as the parts of speech. Okay? For example, noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction and interjection. These all 8 things are known as parts of speech. Now, have you understood the meaning of parts of speech? Once again, I just want to repeat. When we form a sentence, we use a group of words, and when these group of words are divided into 8 different parts, they are known as parts of speech. Now, see students, parts of speech. Now, which are that parts of speech? First is noun, second is pronoun, third is verb, fourth is adverb, fifth is adjective, sixth is preposition, or we can say conjunction. We will take conjunction first. Then comes preposition. And in the last come interjection. Okay. So whenever we are forming a sentence, we are using these 8 different things and we form a sentence. And these 8 different words are divided into, when our sentence is divided into 8 different parts, that is known as parts of speech. So students, have you understood? Let's go further. Okay. So now, in today's period, we are going to start from noun. So our first lesson will be noun. Okay? The lesson that we are going to study is nouns. So students, the topic that we are going to study is nouns. Can you tell me what is the definition of noun? Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, ideas and feelings. Okay? So, the definition of noun you have studied in 4th standard. Then also I just want to repeat once again. Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, ideas and feelings. Okay? So, if I say noun is the name of a person, so many means each and every one of us are having names. Okay? Your parents give you a very beautiful, a very sweet name. That is also noun. Harshali. Then Uday. Then Neeraj. All these are the nouns. Noun is the name of a person. After that, place. You will say yesterday I went to Delhi. So Delhi is a name of a place. So it is also, students, I am writing here definition of noun. Okay, so you will easily understand. Noun is a name of person, place, animal, thing, ideas and feelings. Now see, one by one we are going to see the examples. First we will see, noun is a name of a person. When we are talking about a person, Akshay means when all the students are sitting in the class and when the teacher is talking about Akshay, Akshay please stand up. So from all the boys and girls, only Akshay will stand up. Okay, so Akshay is a noun here. Then Riya, Riya, could you please bring chalks for me? So Riya is also a noun here. Okay, so as I have said that your parents have also given you very beautiful names and your names are also the nouns. Then noun is a name of a place. I have went to Agra. Agra is a name of a place. You will say, I live in Manmad. Manmad, Manmad is also a noun. So here I will write Manmad. Manmad is a name of a place. So it is a noun. Then animal. We have given names to animals. For example, cat, dog, cow. These are also the name of animals and they are also known as the nouns. They also come into the under the category of noun. Then thing. What I am doing? I am just writing with my pen. So pen, the object with which I am writing here is known as thing. So this is a thing and what is the name we have given to this thing is pen. So pen, pencil, eraser, or I am writing on this whiteboard, this is also noun because we have given name to these things and they are also the noun. So next one is ideas. Ideas means whatever ideas you are having in your mind. Okay, now most of the naughty students in the class, they are always busy in playing prank. Okay, so while sitting in the class, they are having idea in their mind, just fool this teacher or just fool my friend or let's play a pranks. So this is also an idea. And if you are having idea to solve a very difficult maths puzzle, this is also your idea. Okay, so idea means solving puzzles or playing prank. Prank on somebody. So that is your. Now students, the last one is feelings. You will say, ma'am, yesterday my friend was very upset. He was feeling very sad. He was feeling very depressed. So when he was sad or he was depressed, that is his feeling. Okay, so whenever you, sometimes you are happy, sometimes you are very nervous, sometimes you are very sad or sometimes you are feeling very overjoyed, very joyful. So all these are your feelings, okay? For example, happiness, happy, sad, these are your feelings, okay? So one by one I have given here, I have written here what is the meaning of noun. Noun is a name of a person. Now are you getting it, students? Noun is a name of a person. Person means Akshay, Riya, Kumar, whatever it is, whatever your names will be, they are known as nouns. Then place, Agra, Manmad, Bombay, Calcutta, Delhi, all are the name of the places and they are also known as noun. Then animals, we have given names to animals, cat, dog, cow, calf, duck, swan. So all these are the nouns. Then things, pen, pencil, whiteboard, eraser. Then all the things, table, chair, all these are the name that we have given to a thing and they are also the nouns. Then ideas, I have already told you, solving puzzles, playing prank, making fun of someone, these are all your ideas, okay? And then comes the feelings. Feelings means you are feeling very happy, you are feeling very sad, you are feeling very dizzy, you are feeling nervous. So all these are your feelings. So overall, we can say that noun is a name of a person, place, animal, thing, ideas and feelings. So up to now, have you understood, student, what is the meaning of noun? I have explained it in detail to you. So I hope that you are getting what is the meaning of noun. Students, अब तक मैंने आपको बताया कि नाउन का मतलब क्या है, ओके? सो मैंने कहा नाउन इज़ अ नेम ऑफ अ पर्सन, किसी व्यक्ति का नाम. नाउन इज़ अ नेम ऑफ अ प्लेस, किसी जगह का नाम. नाउन इज़ अ नेम ऑफ एनिमल, हम एनिमल्स को जो नाम देते हैं, ओके? तो अगर फोर पैरों वाला है और जो भौंकता है उसको हम बोलते हैं कुत्ता. हम ये कुत्ता, ये नाम हमने उसको दिया है, तो वो भी क्या हो गया, नाउन हो गया. देन थिंग, जो भी नाम हमने अलग अलग चीज़ों को दिया है, जिससे हम लिखते हैं उसको बोलते हैं पेन, तो पेन ये क्या हो गया, नाउन, ओके? जिस पर हम बैठते हैं, जिसको चार पैर होते हैं, उसको बोलते हैं कुर्सी, तो दैट इज़ ऑल्सो नाउन. देन आइडियाज, वॉट एवर आइडियाज, जो तुम्हारे दिमाग में शैतानी चलती है या तो फिर कोई डिफ़िकल्ट मैथ्स पज़ल होता है, उसको सॉल्व करना होता है, तो वो सॉल्व करने के लिए जो तुम्हारी आइडियाज़ होती है, वो भी है नाउन्स. देन फीलिंग्स, कभी कभी तुम उदास हो जाते हो, कभी कभी तुम बहुत खुश हो जाते हो, और कभी कभी तुमको नर्वसनेस लगती है, उदास हो जाते हो, तो वो भी क्या है, ये सभी जो फीलिंग्स है, ये भी क्या है, नाउन है. तो कुल मिलाकर हम कह सकते हैं कि किसी व्यक्ति का नाम, किसी जगह का नाम, किसी प्राणी का नाम, किसी वस्तु का नाम, या तो फिर जो हमारी फीलिंग्स होती है, या तो हमारी आइडियाज़ होती है, फीलिंग्स यानी हमारी भावनाएं, तो उन सभी को हम बोल सकते हैं नाउन, ओके? अब तक आपको समझ में आया नाउन का मतलब क्या है? नाउ लेट्स मूव फर्दर. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, अभी हमने नाउन की डेफिनेशन तो देख ली है कि नाउन का मतलब क्या है. नाउ देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ नाउन्स. नाउन के जो फोर विभिन्न प्रकार हैं, चार अलग अलग प्रकार हैं, वो प्रकार अभी हम देखने जा रहे हैं. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ नाउन्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस लेसन, ओके? सो विच आर दे, फर्स्ट इज प्रॉपर नाउन. पहला कौन सा है, प्रॉपर नाउन. सेकेंड इज कॉमन नाउन. थर्ड वन इज कलेक्टिव नाउन. एंड फोर्थ वन इज abstract noun. So from all these four nouns, first noun that we are going to study is proper noun. Which are the first one? Sorry, which is the first one? These are all the four types of nouns, and the first that we are going to study is proper noun. proper nouns are the special name of the persons. Okay? Now see, proper noun means special names of the persons, special names. Okay? When, now students, imagine that you are sitting in a class, okay, and teacher wants to call Akshay. Okay, so what the teacher will say? Akshay, will you please stand up? When the teacher says, Akshay, will you please stand up? So from all the girls and boys, only Akshay will stand up. Okay, because Akshay is a name of a particular boy. Akshay ye jo hai, मतलब जितने भी बच्चे बैठे हुए हैं उसमें से अक्षय ये जो है ये क्या है, प्रॉपर नाउन है, किसी स्पेशल लड़के का नाम है. तो फिर सभी बच्चों में से सिर्फ कौन खड़ा होगा? अक्षय खड़ा होगा. सो अक्षय इज अ प्रॉपर नाउन. ओके, देन कम्स द कॉमन नाउन. कॉमन नाउन मीन्स द नेम्स दैट वी हैव गिवन इन जनरल. मतलब जो नाम हम उसको हिंदी में बोलते हैं सामान्य नाम, मतलब जो नाम हम किसी को सामान्य तरह से देते हैं, या तो फिर जनरल, मतलब हम मतलब सामान्य तरह से वो नाम यूज़ करते हैं, उसको हम बोलते हैं कॉमन नाउन. द नेम्स दैट आर गिवन इन जनरल आर नोन एज कॉमन नाउन्स. फॉर एग्जांपल, कैट, डॉग, बर्ड, एनिमल, ऑल दीज आर द कॉमन नाउन्स. सिटी, boy, girl, man, woman, all these are the common nouns. Okay, are you getting it students? Now let's move further, that is collective noun. Okay, this one is also very interesting. Collective noun, when group of people are sitting together. Okay, so we use a special noun for that. We use a special word for that. Crowd of people. When so many people are gathering on one place, at that time we can say crowd of people. When so many cattle standing on one place, we can say herd of cattle. Okay? When so many birds, they are flying together in the sky, at that time we can say flock of birds. And when so many flies are sitting on one particular place, then we can say swarm of bees. Okay? When so many bees are sitting on one particular flower, then we can say a swarm of bees. So are you getting it students? That is the collective noun. When three lions are sitting together, then we can say pride of lion. Okay? Then so many fishes. You know, have you seen fish tank? In that fish tank, we have put so many fishes together. And at that time, we can say school of fish. That is the collective noun. Okay? So are you getting it students? Jab bohat sare animals ek jagah par kade hain, गाय के बछड़े एक जगह पर खड़े हैं, तो हम उसको क्या बोलते हैं? हर्ड ऑफ काउज. उसको हम क्या कलेक्टिव नाउन यूज़ करते हैं? हर्ड ऑफ क्लाउज. बहुत सारे पंछी जो है वो ग्रुप में मतलब उड़ रहे हैं आकाश में, तब हम उसको बोलते हैं फ्लॉक ऑफ बर्ड्स. क्या वर्ड यूज़ करते हैं हम उसके लिए? फ्लॉक ऑफ बर्ड्स. तो ये क्या हो गया? कलेक्टिव नाउन हो गया. नाउ अगर तीन लायन एक जगह पर बैठे हैं तो हम उसको बोलेंगे प्राइड ऑफ लायंस. ओके, अगर एक फूल के ऊपर बहुत सारी मधुमक्खियाँ भिन भिन आ रही होगी तो हम उसको बोलेंगे स्वार्म ऑफ बीज. क्या बोलेंगे? स्वार्म ऑफ बीज. और जब हमारे घर में अगर फिश टैंक है, वो फिश टैंक में बहुत सारी मछलियाँ होती हैं, तो वो मछलियों के ग्रुप को हम बोलेंगे स्कूल ऑफ फिश. सो दैट आर द डिफरेंट नेम्स, डिफरेंट नाउन्स. दे आर नोन एज द कलेक्टिव नाउन्स दैट वी आर यूजिंग फॉर अ ग्रुप. जो हम ग्रुप के लिए यूज़ करते हैं उसको हम बोलते हैं कलेक्टिव नाउन, क्योंकि सब लोग एक जगह पर इकट्ठे होते हैं, सब एनिमल्स जो है एक जगह पर इकट्ठे होते हैं, एक साथ होते हैं, इसके लिए हम उसको बोलते हैं कलेक्टिव। कलेक्टिव मीन्स ग्रुप, ओके। कलेक्शन, कलेक्शन ऑफ पीपल, कलेक्शन ऑफ थिंग्स, कलेक्शन ऑफ एनिमल्स, तो उसके लिए हम बोलते हैं उसको कलेक्टिव नाउन। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट वन इज द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन? एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन मीन्स समथिंग विच कैन नॉट बी सीन, जिसको हम देख नहीं सकते हैं, जिसको हम छू नहीं सकते हैं। एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन इज दैट कैन नॉट बी सीन और टच, ओनली वी कैन फील इट। हम सिर्फ उसको क्या कर सकते हैं? फील कर सकते हैं, महसूस कर सकते हैं। सो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन का मतलब क्या हुआ? समथिंग विच कैन नॉट बी सीन, जिसको हम देख नहीं सकते, विच कैन नॉट बी टच, जिसको हम छू नहीं सकते, बट वी कैन ओनली फील इट, जिसको हम सिर्फ फील कर सकते हैं, उसको हम बोलते हैं एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन। नाउ विच आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन? नाउ सी, जॉय, सॉरो, एक्साइटमेंट, हैप्पीनेस, सरप्राइज, मिसचीफ, ऑल दीज आर द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन्स, ओके। सो कॉमन, वंस अगेन जस्ट लुक एट द बोर्ड। प्रॉपर नाउन्स मीन्स स्पेशल नेम्स, स्पेशल नेम्स ऑफ अ पर्सन और प्लेस, ओके। कॉमन नाउन्स मीन्स नेम्स गिवन इन जनरल, names given in general, collective noun means when we are using a word for a group, or collection, so that is known as the collective noun. And abstract nouns is something which cannot be seen, or touched, but we can only feel. Feel it. And which are the examples? Joy, sorrow, anger, then mischief, mischief also. All these are the examples of abstract noun. So, students, I hope that up to now you have understood each and everything that I have explained to you. Okay? If you are having any difficulty, you can ask me anytime. Okay? So, what today we have learned? Just take a short recap. Today we have learned definition of noun. What is the meaning of noun? Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, ideas and feelings. And we have also seen the four types of noun, that is proper noun, means special name of a person, common noun, names given in general, collective noun, a word for group of collection, then we use abstract noun, something which cannot be seen or touched, but only can we can feel it, for example, joy, sorrow, anger and mischief. So, this is what I want to tell you. Now, students, see in your textbook, page number 17, okay? Only one thing you have to do, exercise number A, B and C, that you have to solve. But today we have seen types of nouns also. So, you have to solve question number A. What is that? Look at the common nouns in the left column, think and match them with the proper nouns. Means on one side common nouns are given and another side proper nouns are given. You have to match them properly with you have to match common nouns with the proper nouns. Okay, on page number 17. This is your homework. You have to solve it and you have to send me. You have to take the picture and you have to send me on my WhatsApp number. Okay, so have you understood, student? What is your today's homework or assignment? You have to solve question number A. You have to match common noun with their proper nouns. You have to take picture of it and you have to send it to me on my WhatsApp number. So students, that's all for today. I would like to stop here. Till then, you have to take care of yourself. Keep smiling and keep learning. Bye. Bye-bye.